Hello everyone, today we are going to show how to disable the inbuilt laptop keyboard in Windows 10. We will be showing three different methods for this. Two important things to keep in mind before starting. First thing is to keep a USB keyboard and a mouse ready. And ensure that both are working with your laptop. And the second thing is to make sure that the laptop keypad does not contain the power button. Now, let's begin. We have a laptop here with malfunctioning keyboard. As you can see, the keys are getting pressed automatically before login. It can be due to dust or liquid spill on the laptop keyboard. Let's open one notepad to check the issue. We can see the key number 4. Is getting pressed automatically. Even if you use a USB keyboard, this issue will repeat and obstruct your work. It may be different key in your case. So let's go to the first option. This is to use a non-compactable keyboard driver. First, right-click on the Start button. And go to the device manager. You can also open the device manager through computer management. For that, just right click on this PC and select manage. Then computer management will open. From here, select device manager. Then go to keyboards. Here we can view two keyboards. First one is HID keyboard and it is the external USB keyboard. Next is the standard PS2 keyboard. This is the inbuilt laptop keyboard which we need to disable. Select the standard PS2 keyboard and right click, then select the update driver. Click on Browse My Computer for Drivers. Then go to Let Me Pick from List of Available Drivers on My Computer. In this tab, untick the Show Compatible Hardware, then it will show all available manufacturer and models. We can scroll down to view the list. You can select anyone from the list. Here we are selecting the one manufacturer and model. Click the next. You will get driver warning. Click yes to install the driver. Then close the window. Now it's asking for restart give yes to proceed. Now the laptop is getting restarted. The inbuilt keyboard will not work after the restart. If the same driver controls the laptop touchpad and keyboard, you will lose the functionality of both. That's why we initially told you to keep one USB mouse also. Now the laptop has restarted. We can test the laptop keyboard. As you see, it's not working. We can now use an external USB keyboard instead of inbuilt keyboard in case this method didn't work. The next two methods will sort it. Before moving to that, we are showing how to re-enable the inbuilt keyboard which we had disabled. To enable back the inbuilt keyboard, go to Device Manager. Then Keyboard. Select the model which we had changed now. Here it is the thumb shift PS2 keyboard. Right click and update the driver software. Browse My Computer for driver software. No need to change anything. Just click on Let Me Pick from a list of device drivers on My Computer. Select the default standard PS2 keyboard. Click Next and close the window. Then click Yes to restart the laptop. the inbuilt keyboard will be enabled after the restart. Let's move to the second option. Here we will disable the auto driver reinstall option. First, right click on start and select run. Then type sysdm.cpl and click OK. Select the hardware tab. Then device installation setting. Select no and click on save the changes and click OK. Then open device manager. Select keyboard and right click on standard PS2 keyboard. Then select uninstall device. Click on uninstall and give yes. Then will be disabled after the restart. If this option also doesn't work, move on to third option. Here we will change installation restriction using local group policy. The policy editor is only available with Windows 10 Professional and Enterprise Edition. If you don't have this version, you may need to install it manually. First, open run and type gpedit.msc. Click OK. From the local computer policy, select the administrative templates, expand and select system. Then move on to device installation. And finally, device installation restriction. From the right side, select prevent installation of device, note described by other policy setting. Double click on it. And select enabled. Click apply and then OK. Then go back to device manager. Select keyboard and right click on standard PS2 keyboard. Select uninstall device and click on uninstall and select yes to restart the system. The inbuilt keyboard will be disabled after the restart. We hope this video was helpful. We recommended you to keep our system up to date with the latest driver and patches. Thank you for watching.